Hello, beautiful seekers. Small disclaimer before I get into your readings for the month. Tarot readings are just guidance for something that is already there in your subconscious, for something that you already know. At best, you can use it as a confirmation or, you know, just a guideline. You do not make decisions regarding your life based on tarot readings. Everything that you need to know is there within you, and you look within for answers. Now, these cards, however, they help you bring out what is in your subconscious. Now, each reader reads what they see from the cards. It is only the way they interpret from the cards. There are some readers who are clairvoyant, but even channeling is not something, especially when you're doing it as a general reading where there are so many people watching the video, it cannot hold good for everybody. So in a reading, even if you take 10% out of it, if it benefits you, that's all you need to take. You cannot fit these readings for yourself. It's the same thing you must have seen if you follow newspaper predictions, you know, in astrology or whatever. You don't get 100%. You don't get the truth or the answers from these readings. This is just a guideline for you to move ahead. So please do not base your life or make major decisions in your life based on tarot readings or astrology readings. These are just guidance. In fact, the best way to move ahead in life is to be in the now. I know by saying this, it's something that goes against the spirit of perhaps tarot, astrology, or anything that predicts the future. But the fact is, if you stay within the now and not in your past or your future, chances are you're going to be extremely happy and you're going to live a full life. And yet, if there's that one odd niggle somewhere that you really want to know, for that it's all right to come and check out a tarot reading. I felt called to say this to you before this reading so that you do not get hooked on to these readings. They can be extremely addictive, especially when we're going through a low phase or a time wherein we are unable to make decisions. This can just give you, because, you know, on a same day, if you watch two, three readings, every reading can give you a different answers and a different answer. Plus, energies keep changing. So what you see today is not what's going to be 2 days from now. So do not follow the readings, you know, close your eyes and follow them. Get in touch with your intuition. What you know from within is something that cannot be paralleled through cards, through astrology reading, through counseling sessions, through anything. You have the answers within you. So please tap into your inner resources and get those answers. This is just additional help. All right? And with that, let's move into the readings for the month. Catch you there. Hello, my dear Librans. This is Clarity 1129. Welcome to your June 2021 monthly predictions. We shall start with an oracle card for your overarching energy, followed by four cards from the original Rider-Waite for your general love, career, as well as spiritual growth. We'll take out one card from the Sacred Tarot for your health. And at the end of the reading, we'll pull out one card from the Angel Answers for answers for any pressing question on your mind. I'm also introducing this months of the year set of cards from the Tea Leaf Tarot. In case you have a time-specific question, we'll pull out one card from these 12 months and you can get an estimate as to when things will work out for you. Alright, so let's begin. Alright, the overarching energy for the month is fixed moon. Hold your vision. So if there's some idea that you have, dear Librans, which people around you might feel is not all that good, Spirit is asking you to hold your vision. All right, you can see what most people can't see. So keep that. I mean, don't just let that idea go. Keep it there. Hold your vision. You will get answers. You will be guided in time. All right. All right, one card for, wow. The general energy for the month is going to be the Ten of Pentacles. Happiness in the home sector. You're going to build a legacy. You're going to have a lot of success when it comes to your home and things related to your home, your finances. It's a great card to get. For your love and relationships, you get the Seven of Cups. So that's a lot of options for you. For your career, you get the Fool, new beginnings. And for your spiritual growth, you get the Ace of Pentacles. Okay. One card from the Sacred Indian Tarot for your health. You get the Wheel of Fortune. Wow. Somebody else got this too. Okay. I think. No, I don't remember. Anyway. All right. The overarching energy for the month, as I told you, is hold your vision. Now, dear Librans, you know, if anyone has a problem, the best advice you can get is from a Libran, because the way they see things, and they are the kind of people who don't like to put in too much effort, and yet they want to do things the right way. So if you want to get the most effective solution for any problem, you go to a Libran, because with the minimum effort, the maximum benefit that you can take out, where everything is taken care of and they give you a balanced answer, right? So if you have something that has come to your mind, there is something that you want to do, and if people around you can't see it and they tell you it's a useless idea, do not follow what they have to say. Believe in what you are thinking. Now, the biggest issue with Librans is that they are indecisive. So if you have a strong answer and if your gut is telling you this is something that you should look into, listen to your gut. Do not listen to the people around you, okay? In the month of June especially, this is what you're guided to do. Hold your vision. Now, this month is going to be great for your home, for everything related to your home. You will have a lot of money coming in. You will have enough to, you know, take care of things around your home. In all your relationships will be at their best at this time. You know, there'll be a lot of bonhomie and happiness at this time. So that's a beautiful energy to be in. Obviously, it is Gemini season, so which is an air sign, and Libra is also an air sign. So this is a very good month for you as well. For your love and relationships, you get the Seven of Cups. So for singles out there, you have a whole lot of options from to choose from. So the only problem is in countries where the pandemic is on and the second wave is on, like in India, I don't think you'll be going out too much. So maybe these options that you find will be online. All right, but you can keep your options open because it's a good time. For those in relationships, it's just that, you know, it's possible that you're not focused so much on the romance and love of it, but you are focused on the million things that you have to do to get your home life together, all right? Which doesn't seem extremely romantic, does it? But, well, that's how it is. So, for your career, you get the Fool. The Fool is fresh energies. You are at a place where you want to try something completely different. and you just want to take a chance. You know, the feeling is strong. Maybe this is exactly what this hold your vision is for. There is something that you want to do. There's some venture that you want to begin. And you're really charged up for it. And this, with the Fool in the career sector, it tells me that it is something that you can actually move ahead with this month in June. There is something. And then again, for your spiritual growth, you get the Ace of Pentacles, which is again talking about a new idea in the way of your thinking. There is something, some idea which comes to you, which propels you forward in a different direction as far as your career is concerned. And that is the same thing which is also going to propel your spiritual growth. Now, how it's going to happen, I'd like you to tell me in the comments, because I don't know how it's going to pan out, but this is how it is. With this Hold Your Vision card, the Fool and the Ace of Pentacles, I feel they're all connected. That there is something which you are hoping to do. There is something that's brewing inside of you and you want to put it out there. This Fool energy is a very, very powerful energy. This is a major arcana. All right, so this, you really want to do it, and this will also make you see other things differently. So your, as far as the spirituality is concerned, also you'll have a different take. It might, you might be propelled forward. All right. For your health, you get the Wheel of Fortune. So this is about sudden highs and lows. All right. It is also, so basically you may feel energy in spurts. You may suddenly feel very energetic and you want to do some things, and then suddenly you feel depleted of all your energy. So what you have to guard against is to overwork yourself during those highs. Don't do that. Just try and maintain that moderation, even when you are, you know, when you feel the surge of energy inside of you. Don't overwork yourself, because that will make the, when you feel depleted, you'll feel really depleted. So even when you feel energetic, just work moderately. All right. And another thing to guard against or be careful about is your lower back. So don't pick up anything that's heavy. Don't make jerky movements. This is something you need to be careful about. Otherwise, things seem absolutely great for you this month, dear Libra. And we shall take out one answer from the Angel Answers for any pressing question on your mind. Let's see what the angels have to tell you. All right, so here we are. It says the situation will improve. So whatever it is that's on your mind and you're waiting for something, you know, and people are telling you it's not, this is not the right thing to do, hold your vision. The situation will improve and you'll find that whatever you've thought of is actually a very brilliant idea. And if there is a time-specific question for you, then this is your answer. When will this happen? When will I go here? When will a message come to me? When will things happen? Any of those when questions, here's the answer. And the answer, you get January. It's not immediate, but it's not that bad either. All right. So that's all I have for you, dear Librans. Have a wonderful June. Enjoy yourself. Things look really bright and positive for you. Bye-bye.